Hi, it's Bob Kraft of TennisMinistry.org, and Wimbledon Championships are just starting in the year 2011. I'm bringing up different topics. We're a Christian ministry, TennisMinistry.org, and so I try to put it in the context of a Christ-centered thinking as opposed to just playing tennis or watching tennis matches, who's going to win, who's going to lose, that kind of thing, appreciating how well they play. Today I want to bring up the All England Club Committee. It's made up of a group of people who are members of the club, and the members of the club, I believe there's only 300 members of the All England Club. It's a very small number. And, you know, to get into the club, you have to be nominated by an existing member, and then there's a vetting process of looking over your background. It's very much a prestige thing. Of course, people have a lot of money, have maybe a better chance of getting in, or contacts. But that's how the All England Club is set up. So it's a place where you could say money and prestige rules. Now, the committee is a small group of people. I believe there's under 10, it could be 7, it could be 10, who actually manage the tournament. You know, there's a press liaison person, there's the referee, there's the head of the committee, and the recent head, who was the head for, say, 10 or 20 years, I would think 20 years, he recently stepped down this year, and now they have a new one. And I spent a lot of time speaking with him. He knew I was a pastor, he and his wife. We spoke a lot about Christ. We spoke about his family situation. And he's retired now. He stepped down. So they have a new head, which I don't know. And the head changes. You know, I was always just trying my best to be upfront with who I was, trying not to really overstep my boundaries. It's very difficult not to offend people when you're talking about Christ, or you know, if you keep your mouth shut, you can easily not offend people. If you bring up the name of Christ, some people don't like that and other people do. So that was always the hard part, and it required a lot of wisdom. And I found that, you know, with people who were running tournaments, it was actually better not to approach them or talk to them because they had the ability to really make your life miserable. They could stop you from going in tournaments, no matter if a player wanted you there or not. They could disrupt what you were doing in different ways, give you different access to places in the tournament, stop you from going to different places. And I just found that my calling was really not to reach the administrators of tournament. It was to reach the players and those closest to the players, the coaches, their family members. So the administrators, you know, there were times that I would have a chance to share and I felt it was right. And almost always, eventually the administrators found out who I was and what I was doing. And, you know, that was just part of being around a lot. They'd question who you were and they'd want to know and they'd find out from other sources. The committee members there, there's one committee member in particular who really created a lot of problems for me. You know, he came on in the guise of someone who was very interested in what I was doing and wanted to help. And, you know, I think his viewpoint of Christian life was a lot different than mine. And he was a very traditional Christian, 9 to 10 church, go home, that kind of Christian. My viewpoint is different. It's a 24/7 relationship with Christ. And then the other thing was maybe he had some desire to really be well known to reaching the players for Christ. You know, I was someone who was doing it. So it was a very odd relationship, but created a lot of problems for me even to this day at that tournament. So those are some of the pitfalls. But of course, we pray for people who in all circumstances, pray for them. And then it just requires wisdom. Looking back on it now, would I have shared so openly with what I was doing and my contacts? Probably not. I think I learned a lesson there. But on the other hand, God can use all circumstances. And we just need to lift up. Now, there's a management side of the All England Club, which is not part of the committee. And that's the executive director of the club who manages the club on a year-round basis. There's a head pro, there at the club all year round. There are secretaries. And there was one secretary in particular who helped me a lot. And I just want to say thank you. I really am not going to mention her name. I don't think it's important because as I said, you know, there are people who are supportive, and why put her at some difficulty or risk? Just tell you, she helped me a lot. Whenever I needed copies made of things, she did it. She would open doors I couldn't open otherwise, call people, introduce me to people. And she did took a little bit of a hit because of my situation with the committee member who created some difficulties for me. What I would say is that I shared the gospel with every person in that management office, and they knew what I did, and they supported me, and they were always, there was always a fine line for them as to, you know, how much they did versus not doing enough. And I appreciated them. And then there were a couple people on the committee. I think of the committee referee, Andy and Andrew, and you know, he helped me a lot, especially even many years ago. He would introduce me to people as a pastor trying to help the players, and you know, that's the situation. Do pray for the committee. They're not somebody that you're going to hear about on TV too often, but there are people that have different levels of influence. Some of them have a church background, and some of them it's not really meaningful to them much. Just pray for them. Pray that God will work there over the opposition, but also create a spirit of love and a spirit of working together with all Christians so that people can come to know Christ, not just a particular denomination or a particular viewpoint. So that's the committee. Thanks.